One of the best parts of traveling is sampling homegrown cuisine in different parts of the country, and it's no different here in our region. Here at Idlewild Park, it's possible to eat all the traditional amusement park favorites, but there's nothing that says Westmoreland County like a banana split. That's because the treat was actually invented here over 100 years ago. So perhaps it's fitting then, given the food history here, that Snyder of Berlin, which is based in nearby Somerset County, decided to feature Laurel Highlands attractions on all of its snack food bags this summer. Julie Donovan is basking in the free publicity. She's vice president of public relations for the Laurel Highlands Visitors Bureau. And David Martin is president of the Greater Latrobe Laurel Valley Community Chamber of Commerce, which is gearing up for the annual Banana Split Festival. Welcome. Good to have you both here.
Hey, thanks, Bill. It's great to be here. And thank you for promoting these fabulous chips that are produced in Somerset County in Berlin in the Laurel Highlands. And of course, me being a PR person, I'm thrilled for all the free PR that we're receiving.
Yeah, this is great. And Snyder of Berlin, located nearby, makes great snack foods right here in our region. But what a windfall to have them suddenly decide to put your entire portfolio of product on their
absolutely
bags, right?
Thousands, hundreds of thousands of these chips are being distributed throughout their market, just not locally. And we couldn't be happier. And for those that haven't seen the chips, the back gives a great history of the site that they're featuring. The site that I have, the Ohio Powell Falls and the Youghiogheny River.
All right, a classic up here. I've got Fort Ligonier, another great attraction here. And
Powder Mill Nature Reserve, the Great Allegheny Passage, Lynn Run State Park, and these are just a few of the attractions that Snyder's are featuring for us.
I gotta tell you, every PR person's dream to have somebody do something like this.
Absolutely, and we cannot, the Laurel Highlands Visitors Bureau cannot take any credit for this. This was a Snyder, this was their plan, and we are just very happy that they are branding our region for us.
That is so cool. And one of the things that brands our region is, of course, the banana split. Tell me a little bit about the history. It happened in Latrobe,
it
right?
It did. It happened in Latrobe on Ligonier Street in 1904. Was invented by David Strickler when he was working for the Tassel drugstore. And then he took that with him when he moved on to the famous now Strickler drugs on Ligonier Street. That building is no longer there, but 3 years ago, the invention of the banana split was commemorated with a historical plaque.
Okay, very good. But they went beyond the plaque and actually now have created a whole festival there in Latrobe.
We've got a whole weekend that celebrates the banana split with activities for really all ages. A major concert, football games, 5Ks, a color run. Very happy to have the involvement now of Valley Dairy and Ice Cream Joe. Valley Dairy restaurants are the closest thing you can come now to an authentic banana split when you come to Latrobe, and they're a signature sponsor along with Accella Health, so we're thrilled to really bring this to not just Latrobe, not just Westmoreland County, but really the whole region.
Well, I would think you hope that this will be a draw. This is just in its third year, right?
Just in its third year. This is the first year we've had the support of corporate sponsors, and we're really excited to see where we can take it. And Dole is with us as a national sponsor now. Of course, you know, we need the bananas.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, it's a great product placement for a company.
Absolutely.
Like Dole.
Yeah.
No, it's really, well, and it really shows the impact that tourism and hospitality can have on an economy here in this region.
Absolutely, Bill. Visitors spend more than $1.8 billion in the Laurel Highlands, and 22,000 jobs in tourism and hospitality are generated, and that's throughout Fayette, Westmoreland, and Somerset counties.
Wow, $1.8 billion a year.
And the banana split is one very cool special event among hundreds of others that attract visitors from across the Mid-Atlantic and the United States to the Laurel Highlands.
Well, I'm sure you live down in Pittsburgh or in that area. This is your mountain getaway. You can pop up here for the weekend, but people come from all over the place.
They do. You go to a site such as Falling Water and you walk through and you see license plates from every single state and Canada. So tourism is a huge economic generator for the region.
And I guess meaningful in Latrobe. After all, you've got an airport now and Spirit Airlines and everything else going on.
Well, it ties into what Gabe Monzo was saying earlier. You walk through the Latrobe Airport parking lot and you see license plates from really a 5, 6, 7, 8 state area. And Steelers training camp is what's happening right before the Great American Banana Split celebration. So we're very lucky. And of course, our own Arnold Palmer gave us a little bit of a kickoff a few weeks ago when he force-fed Rory McIlroy the banana split. and then they talked about it on national TV and talked about Latrobe and this big event at the end of August. So we're very fortunate here.
That is really exciting. So, yeah, well, I forgot about Steelers training camp. Of course, that's old hat now. They do that every year, but the Banana Split Festival is new. When exactly is the Banana Split Festival?
It's August 28th, 29th, and 30th. It's the last weekend in August, and bananasplitfest.com is the website to go to get a complete rundown of the whole weekend. And we're very excited. We just announced a concert at Memorial Stadium. Never had a concert in that high school stadium before, but Love Betty and will be headlining by the Clarks, which is a favorite band of of several state area, and they're known nationally. So
absolutely.
We're very excited.
Absolutely. You are going big time. And, of course, to find out more about attractions in the Laurel Highlands, you can pick up a bag of potato chips, or I assume you
or
have a
go to laurelhighlands.org for all the summer's events and happenings and what's going on.
All right. Very good. Julie Donovan from the Laurel Highlands Visitors Bureau, David Martin from the Latrobe Laurel Valley Community Chamber of Commerce. Thank you both so much. Appreciate
it. Great, Phil. Thank you.
And next up, tallying the impact of tourism and hospitality across our region. Stay with us.